We love sweet tea from a mason jar. Poor swing picking on an old guitar. Cane pole fishing with a cricket on a hook. Colonel Tom Kelly book may look a little bit southern. It's more than just magnolias and a slower pace.
The first time that, you know, I had a bead on a turkey and it came into fruition, it was like the greatest feeling ever. And all I wanted to do after that is just see other people do that. I'm one of these guys that have probably come into the fold of the turkey hunting world because of COVID, because now I'm stuck at home and I've never been at home. Kind of started having to find some hobbies, you know, to do. And I was like, well, it's springtime. I got a turkey, old turkey vest I could whip out. And basically just through the people that I went with, and I just saw how much they loved it, which in return made me love it so much and care about it and then want to share it with people.
Gary and I met, we're actually from the same hometown. It's pretty ironic that we didn't meet each other until after we left Mobile. And now we've been playing in a band together for, gosh, it's 5 years really, but it feels like about 6 or 7, you know, that we were playing before we even made it official as Muscadine Bloodline. Gary and I both think it's really important to be honest and authentic in your writing and your lyrics. And so we just try our best to draw from life experience, you know, and we've been doing our best at that for a while now. And I just think that we're coming into our own as songwriters even more so than we were when we started. I grew up with 5 sisters. And so it's really ironic that I didn't have that many male figures in my life growing up besides my dad. And Gary has become a brother to me. I mean, me being as inexperienced as I am in the turkey woods, a lot of the guys that I know have told me, and Gary especially, he's like, dude, you may never have another opportunity to hunt turkeys in the snow. You can only kill your first bird once.
Intent.
I didn't know I was gonna get a shot. Right when he
I was behind the camera, so I couldn't see.
I saw him. Gary's such a humble guy. He's like, dude, I just want you to get the bird. It doesn't have to be with me, you know. But he even told me yesterday, he was like, God, it was so cool, you know, just being there with you, you know. And so that's important to me, and I know it's important to a lot of other turkey hunters too. So it's cool, man. It's special. You can tell. It's an emotional thing, and I think that's special how the outdoors can do that. For me, it's even more of the experience than killing the bird. You know, it's the friendships you mend, and it's just an amazing thing, and I can't wait to turkey hunt forever.
I can't watch it.
Now I gotta watch the whole thing.
It wasn't.
Yeah,
we hit
them.
These things will kill
me. Staring their lifeless eyes and burn a camel down. Lawman's coming, gunning, running cold blooded, and I can't turn back. Can't turn the other cheek. Ain't gonna practice what I preach. Always gone for and put it in drive. No, you don't touch another man's wife. When you do that dance, there's no chance in survival. Dead on arrival. Yes,
right. Once you get kind of involved in the turkey world, you start really paying attention to the resource. And because I feel like the more, you know, you love the resource, the more you want to protect it. And so it's just awesome that an organization like NWTF is here for us. And it's just awesome to see the work they've done in different parts of the country and getting to, you know, go hunt these birds.
Gobbler number two.
Well, yeah, I mean, he's definitely not gonna leave those three hens.
After Charlie got his bird, it was my turn. We got to actually track a bird in the snow, which is something you never do, or where I'm from, we never get to do. We started looking down and the tracks are getting real fresh, and we peeked this ridge, and there he was at about 40 steps. Then we had to sit down and just try to make a play for about the next hour and a half.
He got within 35 steps, and I was just like, yeah.
Take out the first day.
Yeah, dude. Sleep in tomorrow,
boo. Sleeping in, baby.
If we're talking about getting your first Merriam turkey, like, this experience was like one for the ages. To not only kill that white-tipped bird, you know, that's that mountain bird, but also in the snow. And it was just like everything you could dream of. It's not about spur length, it's not about beards, it's not about how big the fan was. It's about just going out there and experiencing those things, cherishing that forever.
You don't think about the experience and the memories, you know, until they're made. You know, you don't zoom out and see them until after the fact. But that's one special thing about the outdoors, is after the fact you're like, wow, it was way more than just killing, you know. This awesome a few days here in Wyoming has been life-changing, and I'm really proud to call myself a turkey hunter now.